Hey, hello, my name is Jordan Brown, and we're here in Gainesville, Florida, right outside the city limits. And the name of my farm is The Family Garden. Here at this farm, it's probably like an average Florida soil. It's sandy. There's no clay hardpan down below. A lot of soils in Florida have that clay hardpan, so you would manage it differently. But this is just a really deep, sandy soil. It's pretty average. There's nothing spectacular about it. It's, you know, in its natural state, it's pretty acidic. And we here, the farm is divided up into 8 fields. And before we plant, before every crop, every field gets a soil test. And we're able to manage the soil fertility by composting chicken litter and wood chips and applying a whole lot of compost. And in addition, sometimes using pelletized chicken litter and a liquid product that we can run through the drip tape.
My name is Tony Potenza. My farm is called Potenza Organic Farms. I'm located in Trumansburg, New York, in the heart of the Finger Lakes. I grow a variety of crops. I grow heavy feeders, light feeders, and cover crops. I have a heavy, extensive rotation. I add manure products. I use composted manures. I use belt house chicken manure. I use liquid fish emulsion and a seaweed extract as a starter. I grow a lot of cover crops. I grow clovers, my main cover crop that provides a lot of nitrogen and recycles nutrients. That basically is what I use. The idea of cover crop is aids in recycling nutrients. It reduces erosion, and it's compatible with other crops. We grow a variety of cover crops, mainly clover, with soybeans. So our last cultivation of soybeans, we have a seeder on the cultivator that seeds between the rows of soybeans. We had species evaluation to determine what cover crop would grow best with soybeans, then it wouldn't interfere with harvest. One of the things when you harvest soybeans, your head is close to the ground and you don't need to harvest your cover crop at the same time. We'd like to keep something growing all the time on the soil.
Hi, my name is Juan Reygosa. I operate Terra Preta Farm in Edinburgh, Texas. So mainly we have been trying to incorporate organic matter, or organic matter levels are very low even after 3 years of adding compost. And on top of that, we have been adding soil amendments, the recommendations from the soil lab. That's what we are doing. Also, cover crops, trying to add more organic matter and also nitrogen. So basically, those are the things that we're using right now.
My name is Malika Spencer. I am the owner and operator of Roots to River Farm in New Hope, Pennsylvania, and with a location in Titusville, New Jersey. We've been operating, this is gonna be our 5th season. We use a lot of certified organic compost. We're starting to do our own composting here. We started out with like 1% organic matter here, so that's sort of my biggest push is organic matter, so we can hold on to the nutrients we put in. We do a lot of reduced tillage here. We cover crop a lot. We only till once, and then for a cash crop, and till again for a cover crop, to try and maintain soil structure and soil microbiology. We do soil tests every year, and we will amend according to those per crop.
Hi, my name is Brian England. I'm landsman manager here at Aurora Organic Dairy. Today we are at our High Plains Complex in Gill, Colorado. So for soil fertility, we reuse what the dairy side considers waste. So we're coming back and land applying the effluent water that we capture at the facilities, as well as the manure. We use aged manure. We semi-compost it. It's not officially compost, but we age it and heat it up to help kill the weed seeds. In addition to our pasture management, we take a lot of height samples, clippings to monitor what type of production we're getting off of these pastures. Samples are also sent to the lab for quality so that we can continue to improve the quality of our pastures.
My name is Jean Hediger, and this is my son.
I'm Bryce Hediger.
I do the marketing of the crops from our family farm, and Bryce, along with my husband and his dad, do the growing. They are the farmers. I am the seller. In general, we do not see an organic dry land farming. A lot of people don't spread fertilizer. They're not so convinced that it's a plus-plus situation. I am a big fan of it, and Bryce has become a big fan of it too, because I have really seen the advantages to adding that. You know, when you, I don't want to say double, but we could get 5 bushels more an acre.
It's one of the advantages organic has offered us. When you look at conventional wheat, and I'm making up this number, let's say you're growing 25 or 30 bushel wheat as a conventional farmer. Well, heck, wheat was worth $2 a bushel last year, $2.50. So you're looking at $50, $60 gross an acre. You can't be putting $30 of fertilizer down. Versus if you're farming organically and if you're growing good crop, you can be growing $10 a bushel wheat and you can quickly start to put down some fertilizer expenses. So chicken litter is our first and probably our primary method. And the advantage to that for us, a few things. First of all, anytime you're bringing in manure, you run the risk of introducing seed population, weed seed population. And that's a game we don't want to play, right? We have our own weeds. We don't need to bring in any others. And with chickens, you're looking at a few things. First of all, weed seed doesn't make through it. Make it through their body, make it through their ingestion, and then into our farm. So that was one of the big things that initially brought me over to chicken manure. And then the next one is that chicken manure is very hot in terms of very high in nitrogen. And since we need to be covering large amount of acres, you know, you can carry 10 tons of chicken litter around with you to be covering a back and forth in a field versus dairy manure, for example, or slurry, which we experimented with, has a lot of advantages. But it takes 8,000 gallons of it to cover an acre, and we need to cover several thousand acres a spring. You know, it's just not a plausible battle. So I was pretty warm on chicken litter, and we experimented with it pretty lightly, and in the last couple of years we've really stepped it up and bought all the equipment, and like I mentioned earlier, we have had great results with it.